Hi, my name's Ollie. I'm an Autodesk certified instructor, and today we're going to be talking about how you use the appearance tool in Autodesk Fusion to be able to change what your model looks like, either whilst you're designing it or if you want to do a render. Now, I've got a model of a car wheel here that I'm going to use to show the appearance options. And the first step is to open the appearance tool. Now, you can do this in two places. You can either do it from the modify menu of the design workspace, down at the bottom. It's also A on your keyboard by default. But for now, I'm actually going to go into the render workspace. By default, you'll find the appearance tool up in the main toolbar here with this color wheel icon. And when you click on that, you'll get a box that shows up with a few different sections inside of it that are going to help us apply our materials. The main one is this library down at the bottom. And this is where the Fusion library of materials is stored. And by default, Fusion comes with an enormous number of materials that you can apply to your model. These are categorized into different types of materials. So we have things like metals, woods, and various other materials. You can also import your own materials in the My Appearances section, and you can save materials as favorites if you keep coming back to them. Now, I'm going to use certain materials here, and you can search for these materials from the library with the search bar. So for example, the outside of my tire, I know I want it to be rubber. So I could search for rubber, and my favorites will come up at the top, but then all of the other options will show up down below. To apply a material, all I have to do is click and drag onto the model that I want it to go onto, and it will apply that material. It will also add that material up to the In This Design section of the Appearance tool. And that section contains all of the materials that are contained within this design or have been used. Now, a lot of the materials that are sorted by color have that color in the title. This means that you can search for the color and a lot of materials are going to come up with the different types of material of that color. For example, here, I might choose to take the metal flake black color and apply it to my wheel hub. Now, what you might notice is that some of these colors will have this download symbol to the right-hand side of them. What that means is that those materials haven't yet been downloaded from the Autodesk servers down onto your computer, so you won't be able to apply them yet. All you have to do is click on that little download symbol, and it will take a couple of seconds to download it, at which point you can then apply it. Now, there are lots of instances where you don't want to apply the material to your entire body or component. You might have noticed that so far when I've clicked and dragged, all of the faces on those bodies and components have updated to be the new color. Now that's absolutely fine if that's what we want, but we can change this with the top apply to section. By default, the material will apply to the entire body. However, I could change this to select only faces. When I do this, I can choose to drag a specific color onto a specific face. And that will only apply that material to that specific face on my model. If I changed my mind and I actually wanted to change the color of my wheel hub, I could do this. I could go in and I could add a material. Now I could theoretically drag this onto my hub. I could also actually drag it onto the component in my browser. Now what that will do is it'll bring up this warning because that hub currently has two different appearances applied to it. And doing this and applying this red color to the entire body will override the white strip that I've added. So what it's asking me here is whether I want to remove the appearances that I've applied to individual faces and override it with the new color, or I can keep the appearances that have been applied to those individual faces and change everything else on my body. Now, ultimately, this is one way of doing it, but the issue is that my In This Design section starts to get a little bit messy because I start to accumulate colors and appearances that are no longer being used in this design. So instead, I'm going to undo that, and this time we're going to do it slightly differently. Instead of dragging my appearance from the menu onto the body, I'm going to drag it over the color that I want to replace in this design section. Now what that's going to do is it's going to replace any instances of that appearance being used in your model, whether that's 10 faces or 3 bodies, it doesn't matter. It will replace all of the instances that that appearance is used with the new appearance. And it means that a old appearance that's no longer being used isn't left in this design section. So you keep that section nice and tidy and it's only showing the appearances that are currently in use in your model. Whilst the Fusion material library is extensive, there are lots of instances where you want a very specific color or material type. What we can do there is we can take any of the materials that are being applied by Fusion and we can right click on any of these options in this design section. When I do that, I have a few options that come up, including adding them to favorites, unassigning them and deleting them from the in this design section, duplicating them, or I can edit the material. When I do that, I can change the name of this specific material, but I get some basic settings that I can use to change the color. So for example, I could choose to make this a much more suitable Fusion Orange. There are also some material settings that I can change, including roughness and reflectance in this case. Or I could apply specific Pantone color libraries and colors to my design. I also have some more advanced options. If I edit and then press the advanced button, I get the full range of options that I can change, including things like emissivity to give out light. I can add relief patterns through bump images. I can do cutout or do more advanced highlight controls with light fall off and more. Different materials have slightly different settings inside of them. For example, my rubber material has different settings that are available to me. And because it's using a bump map, I can change the scale of that map to adjust what that material is actually looking like. If I go inside the advanced menu, you can see how this roughness map has been applied to this material. Now, ultimately, being in the render workspace will give me better lighting conditions to understand my materials. But even better than that would be to do an in-canvas render. And by turning on in-canvas render, I'm beginning the render process on my computer. This will include much more detailed shadows and lighting conditions that will allow me to refine my materials even further. Now, whilst this is a valid rendering technique, it will update every single time something changes, such as the position or the material that you apply. But you can also change your render settings in the top for in-canvas render settings to adjust this to be the fast or advanced settings, where fast will really easily allow you to change materials and get a really good idea of whether that material and appearance looks how you want it to look in your render. Ultimately, once you've applied all your materials, you can then play around with your scene settings and then create your render and apply that and send it off to be used. Hopefully you now have a good idea of how to apply appearances and the different options that you have when you do. This is going to allow you to really capitalize on your designs and get really nice renders out of it that represent how you want your model to look. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up down below. Feel free to subscribe to the channel, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.